Welcome, my dear student. Digital learning class of mathematics. As you all know, we are in chapter number 2, that is related to polynomials. In polynomials, we are dealing nowadays with exercise 2.5, that is related to algebraic identities. So in algebraic identity, we have studied number of identity. So today I am going to tell you something tricky that is very helpful to find out sometime answers when it is given cube roots. So first, let's see a plus b whole cube, that is a cube b cube plus 3ab into a plus b, that you have studied already. Now new thing that you are going to study, that is x cube plus y cube plus z cube is equals to 3xyz. So directly we can write 3xyz, but condition is there if x plus y plus z is equals to 0. So let's see this question, how we can verify. Let's take x equals to 2, y is equal, x is equals to 3, y is equals to 2, and z is equals to minus 5. So add these numbers, 2 plus 3, 5, 5 minus 5, 0. In such cases, when you are getting 0 after adding all numbers and it is asked to you a cube, b cube plus c cube, so just multiply the numbers, simple, no need to find the cube. Here it is not required to find the cube. Here if you are interested to calculate the power 3, so directly without calculating actual cube, you can find out a right answer. So let's see, 3 into a value is this, b value is 2, c value is z. So 5 to z 10 and 10 9 z 90 is your answer with negative sign. So let's start with the today's topic. Today's topic is question number 13. If x plus y plus z is equals to 0, so prove that x cube plus y cube plus z cube is equals to 3xyz. How we can prove it? This is the first task. So let's start. First we need to write what is given to us. So I need to write here, we have given, we have given, so what is given to us, that is given x plus y plus z is equals to 0. This is given to us. So from the same, if you are thinking to do little changes, like you can write x plus y, if you are shifting this z from left to right, so it become minus of z. Then now what we need to do, we need to do cube both side. Cubing both side. So if you are doing cube both side, what will be your step? That is x plus y raised to power 3 is equals to minus of z raised to power 3. So in this case, when you are getting x, y and z is equals to 3, then your task is to find out the exact value, that is z. So how to calculate z from here? Let's see. Here we can apply directly formula, that is a plus b whole cube. So what would be my next step? It become a cube plus b cube plus, what is the next one? A cube plus b cube plus, we will get 3ab. 3ab, that means I got here x and y into x plus y is equals to z cube. This is okay. Now you can check from this equation where we have selected this one. One. Here you can see I have written x plus y is equals to minus of z. Is it clear? So it is minus of z. That means wherever I have written x plus y, there I can write minus of z. So let's see what I will get. I will get x cube plus y cube plus 3xy and this become minus z. This one, it become minus of a z. Then 1 minus z is on next side, that is minus z cube. So let's see, if you are taking this z cube toward this side, it become plus, so it become x cube plus y cube and minus z cube become plus z cube. And this term, I am shifting this side, so it become minus 3xyz. How it become positive? This is very important. Earlier minus sign is here, so it will come here. Plus into minus, minus. So that if I am suppling this whole term toward this side, so it become plus. So now you can check this answer. This is x plus y plus z cube is equals to 3xyz. And you can write hence proof. hence proved. So this type of question is very interesting and easy. How to solve? I told you, first write what is given to you. From here, write x plus y is equals to minus of z. Do cube both side. If you are taking cube root both side, so it become this one. Now shift this term to this side, so it become plus z, and this term is negative, so it become 3xyz. So let's see the application of this formula. How we can utilize this formula in the question number next? Which of the without actual calculation, calculate the cubes of the following. That is minus of 12 raised to power 3, 7 raised to power 3, and 5 raised to power 3. Find the cube of these, sum of the cubes. So how to solve? Start this as I told you. So in this case, you can do simply, first write here 12 plus 7 plus 5. Simple task. Add these, what you will get? 7 plus 5, 12. So minus 12 plus 12. What would be your answer? 0. 12 minus 12 is 0. So the next thing that you need to keep in mind, once it is 0, so you can utilize this one. So we can write, now we can write, that is minus of 12 cube plus 7 cube plus 5 cube. So what would be my answer? This is why identity number this, that is x cube plus y cube plus z cube is equals to 3xyz. But condition is this. This condition is satisfied. Sum is equals to 0. So I can write 3. The value of a is minus of 12. Value of b is 7. And value of c is 5. So let's see now. You can multiply it in your own way. Or you can select a better number for multiplication. So I am doing in this way. 7. 3 into 7 I am not touching. I am doing first 12, 5 is 60. Minus of 60. Then 60 I am going to multiply 60 into 7. So 7, 6 is 42. 420 into 3. So 0 first. Then 3 to just 6. And 4, 3 is 12. So your answer would be minus of 1260. So this is the answer of question. What I did? Without calculation, if you are calculating 12 into 12 into 12, so it is so long, so better do shortcut. Just add this number. If you are getting is equals to 0, then directly write 3xyz and multiply these three number, you will get the accurate answer. Similarly, I want to give you a hint for next one. This one is the next. Similarly, add these. First task is to do adding. 28 plus minus of 15 minus of 13. So you will get 28 minus 28, that is equals to 0. So directly you can do here on board, that is 28 raised to power 3 is plus minus of 15 raised to power 3, then plus minus of 13 raised to power 3 is equals to 3 into 28 into 15 into minus of 15 into minus of 13. So you can multiply this and you can find the answers. Simple, these questions are very easy. Just you need to learn the trick. If add a number, you are getting is number is equals to 0, then directly write 3 into first number into second number into third number. Multiply and you will get the answer.